We are based at Pune, sorry, Thane, and we are 100 years old company, and we took our anchor by electricals with 55 back, and we are doing almost close to 7.55 trillion in Japanese yen. And we have got almost 475 companies in all over world. And we have gone into appliances. Panasonic has been known to appliances, avionics, eco solutions, and automobile industry. And we fall into eco solutions. And we fall into ISAMIA. We call it as India, South Africa, Middle East, and Asian countries. We operate from India. And yes, sir. So we have got a presentations and presence in all over the world, and we install close to 4 gigawatt of solar modules, which is predominantly in Japan, USA, and European countries. In India, we launched 4 years back with high efficiency modules. Predominantly, we started our operations in rooftop applications. Now we have started even our ground mounted application in Sira, which is in Tumkur, close to 30 megawatt. And we have got factories in India, say from Jajar, we have got an appliances factory, and we have got a battery factory in Baroda. And anchored by Panasonic, we have got a manufacturing place in Daman as well as in Haridwar. And Panasonic Corporation, we fall into Panasonic Eco Solutions, and it has been Anchor Electricals has been owned by 100% stake owned by Panasonic. And coming to solar, we started 27 years back. You must be aware of Sanyo Electricals, which is into calculators and watches you should see. And we are the pioneers in into amorphous silicon, which has been used in spacecraft. We developed a unique technology called HIT. It's called heterojunction intersilicon technology, where we're using a n-type silicon cell, and it's a 5-inch square cell, and above that we apply a layer of amorphous silicon. So we take the characteristics of both monocrystalline as well as the amorphous silicon, and which is of a silicon cell of 99.19 purity, which is highest, which has been used in Intel also. So what we require is only 75 square feet of area for installing a 1 kilowatt of solar module, whereas in poly and mono we'll be requiring almost 100 square feet. What is HIT? It's again a monocrystalline module which uses a n-type silicon cell, and above that we have got amorphous silicon. Why we are using amorphous silicon is actually to work on all light spectrum, and it has got a least thermal coefficient, say around 0.258, which has been lowest in the industry. And starting from silicon to ingot, wafer, and cell, and the modules, all manufactured in our own. And we got a cell manufacturing facility in Oregon in USA. And we got a module manufacturing plant in, two plants in Japan and one plant in Malaysia. And the R&D we have is almost 25.6% as cell efficiency. On mass production, we are doing almost close to 22% of the efficiency which are using it out. And what is the advantage in using HIT? With a limited space, roof space, you can able to generate more amount of power. See, in terms of RPO or SPO, you are concerned. Say, you have been a constrained in roof space where you can install more amount of module. Whereas HIT, say around 1.6 square meter of area, we can generate almost 325, which is equivalent of a 260 watt of polycrystalline modules. So there is a catch, and second thing is the temperature is almost say 45 degree to 50 degree of temperature in almost every places. So when the temperature goes up, your power generation has been lesser. So with the help of amorphous silicon, which have been added here, we can able to generate more amount of power, which is almost close. If you're going to compare with space to space, it'll be around 30% more. And if you're going to compare from module to module, it'll be around 13% more efficient. And all the modules have been tested with a 3 times of IEC, which you do. And it has been a 100% PID free. And first year, the very first year, you will not have any degradation. And after that, there will be year on year 0.33% of degradation, which you can see in polycrystalline of 0.7%. And it's been a symmetrical and flexible cells. And after 10 years, you will have a power output per se around 94.8% in a HIT module, whereas compared to of a 90.6 in polycrystalline modules. Less micro cracks, since and it's been a pyramid in structure, we can able to generate more amount of power. And apart from the IEC, we do a close to in-house 20 tests of various tests like heat dampness test or even the salt mist test, which has been to increase the durability of the product. See, as many of them have spoken about the selection of raw materials, yes, the EVA, it matters a lot. Not only it shades changes in color, but it even applies to the snail crack test also. So that's the one thing you should be able to understand. And we have got a provision of a water drain facility also in HIT modules. And there is a less chance of failure rate. We almost say 0.003% is a failure rate which have been assumed. And there is no toxic materials like lead has not been anywhere used over there. And what you require is actually a lesser roof space where you can able to generate more amount of power. What you got is the more amount of watt per meter square, that is the power density has been more, and lesser degradation in the modules, and lower failure rate, which results to a higher cash flow as an investor if you see, and your higher profit for the 25 years down the line, and the lower financing risk. As an investor, what you'll see is the return on investment. If you're going to compare with the poly to HIT, yes, your return on investment will be around 3 years or 3.5 years for a polycrystalline modules, where in HIT you can stretch one more year, but in terms of power generation, say you can earn your money within 4 years, 4.5 years. So after that, it's going to be a much more higher than the polycrystalline modules. And not only on HIT, we also manufacture polycrystalline modules and the mono and perc modules too. And we have got warehouses all over India. We have got in Bhiwandi, we have got in Palwal for north, and we have got in south. And we did installations close to 60 megawatt in India, pointers in the for software companies and Jaguar in Bhiwandi, close to 67 megawatt. And predominantly we are focusing more on the rooftop application. Not only on EPC, we also do a module supply, and we take care of the O&M too. And lastly, we are going to have a technology tie-up with Tesla, which we have started almost close to 1 gigawatt of manufacturing, which has been up in Buffalo in New York, and 350 megawatt has been already started. By next year, we'll be close to 1 gigawatt of. And we also having a technology partner with Toyota with for the Prius car with the flexible modules, which had been economically viable. And with, since we are also a battery manufacturer, Panasonic is a lithium-ion battery manufacturer, so we are a technology partner for even to Tesla also. So by this, I think I can conclude the sustainable performance without compromise on Panasonic. Thank you very much.